If you get caught committing a crime and want to get off, you better not get caught dressing the wrong way. According to Paper Magazine, there's actually a certain way you can dress in a courtroom or an interview so that you appear innocent.
Wow.
Tips to look courtroom chic include sticking to solid colors, staying away from patterns, and trying to look demure by keeping your hair simple. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and going easy on the makeup.
Oh, Lord.
For example, Casey Anthony, who was photographed in the past wearing skimpy outfits for a hot body contest, showed up to court looking like this.
Oh, wow.
So, ladies, what's your verdict when it comes to courtroom clothing?
I'm curious what you think,
Jeannie. Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
For fashion.
For fashion.
I definitely believe that colors and textures can convey a position.
Yeah.
If you're smart about it or you're tactful about it. I think the safest is always black. It's a power color, but it says I'm neutral. But if I was going into court and I had to, like, play like I was innocent,
who would you wear?
I would always go with spa-like colors. Go, like, soft beige, gray, sky blue, peach, anything that's soothing, because then it shows that you're earnest. It says you're genuine colors that are inviting. You don't want to wear anything too bold, polka dots, anything too loud kind of screams that you're assertive. And in a courtroom, you just want to seem, you want to seem pleasant and genuine and earnest, you know? I also think necklines, like, of course you don't want to show cleavage, and you don't want to over-sensualize your body, so don't wear anything too clingy. I almost would wear something a size bigger, just so it's not about body at all, but it's about respect in the courtroom. Mm-hmm. And wear a high neckline, because that always gives you a regal or an astute look.
So young women that might think that showing their cleavage to a male judge is
not a good thing.
That's
it's not.
No.
No.
Well,
that just says that you're really thoughtful. T-H-O-T.
Back in
you want to be a top?
Okay.
You want to be a top?
Back in the 70s, people used to suggest that you would dress frilly and glam, like a ladylike, like Patty Hearst. In the 70s, she was convicted of, like, bank robbery and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And so the way they did her was that they made her clothes a little bit bigger with the bow tie.
That's what I'm saying.
And on the other side is Lorena Bobbitt.
Mm-hmm.
They had her with the shoulder pads to look, you know, really feminine. Lorena got off. If I'm correct, she did get off.
I just recently watched the documentary that Jordan Peele did about her, and they definitely spoke about how important it was for her to look a certain way in the courtroom to get the message across that, yes, she was a young, cute girl, Ecuadorian too.
Right.
Random. but people used to say that was like the claim to fame. Like, if I told people I was Ecuadorian, they would be like, oh, Lorena Bobbitt. I'm like, we also have Rico Suave. With that being said, she was from another country, obviously in Ecuador. I think she was used to being prim and cute and wearing cute outfits, and they definitely wanted to bring that down so that they could actually hear the story that she really was an abused woman.
Okay, do you think, honestly, that affects the judge's result of the case? Because,
I'm
sure the judge has done his or hers research, and they can see, wait a minute,
But what about the jury?
Okay.
Because back in 2010, Lindsay Lohan, she was all over the place in her court attire. Sometimes it was simple, sometimes it was sexy.
Yeah.
It depends, you know.
Uh-huh. I mean, on the left is very chic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what's crazy if you kind of go a little bit deeper in it? For most women, if you want to appear, again, innocent, you're going to wear what you just said, which is boxy. I said one size up clothing. If you wear anything a little bit more showy and anything that shows curves or femininity, the stereotype is that you seem like you could be manipulating or you could be seeming devious.
So you would use your body to manipulate what you want, and then again, you don't come across as innocent.
Yes, it's kind of messed up that today we have to be the antithesis of that bad stereotype by conveying a different look, because showing your body still today is a bad sign for women. Isn't that kind of weird?
Interesting.
Yeah.
You know?
Kardashian will be in the courtroom in the future at some point. She's studying to become a lawyer as a fashion icon.
And on that note, we're going to take a break. There's more Girl Chat on the way right after this. You're watching The Real.
I wonder what she'll...